tree to start us off today. The last day of August.
Woo!
Way.
Hey.
Do you know which country I played there, Trevor?
Was it Finland?
Because it could have been. I saw you slapping your hands together.
Yes,
very good. Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Alan's Music Centre's YouTube channel, where we talk about all things wonderful in the world of home organs and so on. And today, we're not playing an organ, actually.
We're playing on the OX1, which is an organ by any other name.
It is.
Yes.
Almost a single keyboard organ.
Yeah.
I think so.
It is,
and
yes.
It is, absolutely. I'm glad we agree. Moving on. Yes, we're playing the wonderful Wersi OAX 1 in this lovely pearlescent white finish. And it's great to have you company this morning. And morning, Trevor.
Yep. Hi, everybody.
Welcome.
Right, we're on that one.
We're on that one.
No, we're on both of them, actually. We've got
well,
both. Very technical picture and picture.
Very, very
exciting.
Confusing.
Yes.
I can't look.
Go on, we'll just go
that
over there.
Thanks.
There we go.
Oh, right,
down that one.
You see, three comes off.
Usually more.
Two.
Yeah. Actually, we're just debating when we came on about the buffering lag about when we start recording.
Yes.
And actually, even though we waited, it was still a little bit of
really.
Yeah, it's weird. How long the lag is? Anyway,
should
we say hello to everybody?
Absolutely.
So we got a good crowd today, actually.
Wow.
Remember to join us on the Tuesday because it's a bank holiday, which I only remembered on Friday when I was with Lucy. On her live show, so we'll see you on Monday. No, we won't, because the bank holiday.
Yes.
So let's do a shout out to Rob Appleby.
Hello, Rob.
From Georgieland.
Rob came and visited us in the shop the other way.
Oh, you said yes. I missed
yes,
him. Yes,
lovely.
Yeah.
Yes, you made sure you were out that day. I know, it's lovely. It's lovely to, because we sort of get to know everyone so much via Patreon and YouTube, and then suddenly it's great to put an actual
face to the voice and the text and everything.
And so it's lovely to see Rob. We've got the grand tour.
Excellent.
Yes.
It's like coming to see the Harry Potter set and things, you know, people want to come see where the magic happens.
Absolutely. So is this it? Yeah.
Yeah,
is this really it? Yeah. So, yeah.
There's not much more to see, no.
Absolutely.
We need to get some of those cards printed that we sign, you know, like a picture thing that we could hand out, you know, promotional
stuff. We did joke, because down in the showroom, we now have a large display TV, which is on the wall, and it plays our videos during the day, which is really nice. But we did joke about putting a couple of small ones hanging in the window, like those TV studios, and you see them winning a lot.
See what's going on live.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Maybe we should have like a selfie area, where people come and can have a selfie down.
Oh yeah, the green screen. Yeah, that's a good idea. Yes.
Anyway,
interesting.
Hi to Ernie from Cedar Falls, in Iowa. Colin Etheridge.
Morning, Colin.
Hi, Colin. John Sinkovich. Good morning, hope you've enjoyed your holiday. Yeah, it's very nice. Little bank
it
holiday,
was, yes, it went, yeah.
Weather wasn't all that fantastic, as it hasn't been all summer. But
they were saying in the news the other day that apparently in England we were a bit sort of like stuffed with the lack of bank holidays, because Wales and Scotland have several more.
Yeah. Well, I know Scotland particularly has one after New Year's Day, which I think is a really good idea.
What happened yesterday? I don't remember.
Actually, in Ireland, they have one after St Patrick's Day as well.
So do they? Okay.
So not on St Patrick's Day, but the day after is the bank holiday.
So what we're saying is we need to be a bit more patriotic.
We need a hangover day.
After St George's Day,
we need hangover days.
There you go. A cider day, yeah.
But we had a nice day, actually. I went and saw Dippy yesterday. Dippy is the nickname for the Diplodocus fossil skeleton that's been travelling around the country.
It is.
And actually, I was just saying to Lucy, it's quite interesting that the concept is that this is something that's been in the Natural History Museum in London for decades. In fact, I remember going to see it when I was a child with my granddad. That just shows how old it is.
I mean,
it's not just a fossil. It was around for
when I was a child. Was everything in black and white?
They decided that they were going to change the Natural History Museum, so they replaced it with a blue whale, I think.
Mm-hmm.
And so rather than put it into storage, they decided to send it on tour around the country.
Brilliant.
So even though COVID interrupted it, it's been doing this grand tour around the country, and it's been in Norwich for the summer in Norwich Cathedral, which is an amazing place.
Great
space. If anybody comes to Norwich, we are blessed with an amazing cathedral. We've got two amazing cathedrals, but the Church of England one is quite spectacular inside.
Do you know when my wife's family came over, they didn't want to go and see it.
No.
And I said, this is the cathedral. And she goes, yeah, we're going to go to the Catholic one, the Catholic. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And I said, well, that's only built about, late 1800s, I think that is, isn't it? So I said, but let's go in here. And so then, because Jennifer was expecting Abigail, then she complained that I'd made her walk all the way to the Catholic Cathedral. Hang on a minute, I'll be getting used to this, being it my fault. Yeah, but no, it is. Did they complain like they did about the Helter Skelter?
No, they were very happy because it's, I mean, that's the whole point of the story is to it's been incredibly popular. Yeah. Wherever it's gone, it's had literally tens of thousands of visitors. So it's actually had many more visitors by being on tour than it ever would have done by just sitting in London. Yeah. So maybe that's something.
And as you say, the cathedral, you can go in there and just wander for an hour.
It's stunning. And just seeing it in that environment.
The gardens, amazing. Yeah.
In fact, for our Patreon members, I'll put some pictures of Dippy up on there.
Excellent.
Where were we? Derek Matt says, good day to everyone. 2.85 installed on his 500, no problems. Well done, Derek. In fact, that's what we're here to talk about today, is 2.85.
Fingers crossed, everything will be demonstrated well.
Neville Jolly, good morning, Trevor and Tom and everyone. 2.85 installed, no problems. Thanks.
Neville, well done. Yeah. Excellent.
Colin Etheridge says, me too, Derek and Neville. Well done.
This is very encouraging.
Everybody's done very well with it. I mean, I did a Patreon video last week where I kind of said, you know, look, this is where you download it from and you download it here and do that. And said, you know, if anybody needs us to send them a sticker, we can do it.
Absolutely.
Just pay for the stick and the postage and packaging. But people are doing very well by themselves.
Excellent.
Al Smith has got 2.85 on his organ, so he's good.
Well done, Al.
Peter Dean says, good morning. We have already tried for the opera settings you have sent. Any chance of being able to listen and watch as the presets change? Didn't Lucy do that in the video, that she normally chats through the presets that she's done and as she's playing? Yeah, does she not do that?
I'm still catching up on the series.
So, okay. Yeah. So when on Lucy's Q&A on Fridays now, what we realised is that she obviously does special registrations for a song and talks through them. It's like, well, when we put that on Patreon, we can actually put a copy of the presets.
Absolutely.
So people can have a go at it. What? Yes.
Great idea.
John Bradley says, hello everyone, hope you all had a good back
morning,
holiday
John.
On our well. Yes. Steve Homan, good morning Tom and Trevor, hope you had a good weekend.
And Pat. Pat's probably there.
Colin says he's going to have to watch on Alan Javu, smart meter fitted at some point this morning. Yes.
Watch again. Do you know, my electricity ball keeps trying to get me to have a smart meter, but I've got solar panels.
Yeah.
And I was always told they don't work with smart meters.
Ah.
So it's kind of like, they work with digital ones, not with smart ones. The problems of my life.
I must admit, they fit the smart meter to ours, and it doesn't really make any difference.
No, you still have to pay the bill.
Still got to pay the bill. I mean, it saves you having to read the meter because it sends the meter reading in automatically.
Yeah.
But I must admit, I'm not that switched on that I could switch on.
Hey.
That I'm sitting there looking at the thing, monitoring and going around switching off things to. Because we've got two kids, so I'm always turning off the lights anyway. how many times have I told you? We have so many devices that want to charge continually.
Well, there we are.
Anyway. where were we?
Alan
Javu. I always thought that Deja Vu was the favourite, the funniest one, on the Dave channel.
Yeah.
The catch-up channel was called Dave Javu. John Singvich, morning Peter. I've got to get the music for the Phantom. Well, it's available in one of the EZ playbooks, actually.
It is.
I think that's what Lucy was playing it from, actually.
Absolutely.
Peter Steen, I have it already, John, and the new Lucy books arrives this morning, I hope. Yes, we had a bit of confusion with Lucy. Lucy chose a book to continue, because the big news is Lucy's finished. Hang on. Her 50 song book.
That's worth something, isn't it? Once I actually find the registration. There we go.
Lucy has actually made her way through all the 50 songs in the Back Larry songbook.
Excellent.
A bit like the kind of the Moby Dick thing, you know, once you've finally got the way, I was like,
What do you do now?
So to follow up, she chose a book from the shelves, announced it to everybody on Patreon, and it turns out that you can't get that book.
She's now doing
Far Side Favourites. So for all our Patreon members that are following Lucy on there, I'll put a description of the book on there.
Absolutely.
We've got loads in stock now. That's why we chose that book, because we could get loads for it.
If you do have that book at home already, it is actually the third version now.
Third edition. And it's much cheaper than the previous one. I think the one she chose before was about £17. This one is only £5.95, so it's good value for money. Anyway.
Where were we? Yes. 2.85.
Yes, Trevor Hyam, good morning. Hi, Trevor.
Always good
to see another Trevor. Alan Robinson, greetings, Trevor and Tom from a sunny Leeds. John Singovitz says he loves Thai Yellow Room. Love it. Yeah, that's a good song, that.
I'm very pleased you knew what I was trying to play.
Yeah.
It's a problem, that song, because the verse is a little bit, there's hints of the main theme in the verse, so it's very...
Actually, it's one of those few songs, many songs now, actually, that I still need the little bit of cue music because I can't remember perfectly. Right. And also, what I tend to go into is, not Thai Yellow Room, but Save All Your Kisses For Me.
Yes.
because they're basically kind of the same. Eurovision Song Contest. That was Brotherhood of Man. Kisses for me. Save all your kisses for me.
Moving on.
We ended up doing this with a lot of Lucy. We're doing lots of singing on Friday as well. Yeah, just forget the organs. We're just coming to do karaoke for you on a Tuesday morning.
We did that one year at Peterborough at the show, didn't we? We did a karaoke.
We had a karaoke evening, yeah. Well, because we had one of our customers who sadly is no longer with us anymore.
Dino was a great voice, really great Frank Sinatra,
and he did a great evening. Peter Brown, good morning, Trevor and Tom. Nice to have you both back and look forward to the Wersi upgrade info. Denise Masters, hi, Trevor and Tom. Pete Sanders, good morning. Great to have another helping of Wersi this week. Yeah, we have lots of catch up with Wersi this week. More Patreon videos on Wersi this week as well. Elizabeth Polinski, hey, Nebraska here. Hello, Nebraska.
Morning, Elizabeth.
John's here. He's waiting for a tropical storm to come through Pennsylvania. Yeah, yes. It's serious weather in America, isn't it?
Safety to all our friends over in the States.
And he says, I see Tom is following in Trevor's footsteps with a nice drink. Yeah, Tom.
I am sorry to drink coffee. I hate drinking. I as a professional, I'm drinking. One doesn't drink on stage. But Joshua was up a bit early this morning, so yes.
All our gas, electricity, water meters are smart here. And he was able to get the crooner's book and she changed it. Yes, sorry, John. but it's still a good book to have.
It's a nice book to have. Yeah. The problem with the Hal Leonard series is not all the books are published for sale outside of America. Mm. We can get many books, but there's a lot of them which are kind of firm staples. I think she's also going to do something similar at Peterborough for her workshop as well. Mm. So, and of course, those of you who are coming to Peterborough, and we have a little thing there called the music store where we have music books and software packs, and the artists can sell their CDs. Oh, by the way, we still have. I'm talking of Peterborough. Did you like the segue?
It's just effortless.
due to sort of various amazing work by Jill, our bookings accountant lady, we've actually got one or two. New rooms available, including one or two downstairs as well. So, if any of you thinking of coming but find the stairs a little tricky, there are about four or five rooms now available. But it's amazing, we've got some great people coming.
And you don't have to share with Tom to get them either.
Don't have to share to get them. But the artists have been speaking to Brett and to Robert, and everyone's very excited, and fingers crossed everything will be tickety boo come October. They're about eight, 9 weeks away now,
Very scary. Start practicing.
Yes, and so we've nearly got all the packs put together, and Trevor and I have got to decide what to wear. Shall I stop waffling and get on with it?
So today's video is been very exciting because, as I say, Wersi did release the new update for their OAX instruments. Somebody who's not aware, one of the unique features of the Wersi is because it's a software-based instrument, it can be updated, new features added, improvements made, bugs sorted out, all kinds of things, apart from the spiders that we get this time of year. We've had some corkers already in our house.
Bet you have.
All
I hear is, Tom! And it's just when you got into bed, a nice book.
So when a new version comes out, it's very exciting because we get to load it into your instrument, which you can either download yourself from the Wersi.net website, or we can send you a memory stick. It will give you new features on the organ. It will update things, give you new sounds, new features. So it's a very exciting time when a new update comes out.
It is.
And there's lots of interesting things to talk about
there
on this
is.
Version. So I will stop waffling and hand you back to Tom.
Yes, and when I forget what to do, Trevor will segue in. I spoke to Ulrich a few weeks ago, and he said that hot on the heels of 2.85 is 2.86. At some point, which is going to be the version of the software that will integrate our very first software activation pack, which so you'll be able to treat yourselves to this one, and it's going to be called World of Organs, which we've talked about and demonstrated before on the channel, but it is actually going to become a reality now. So we'll keep you up to speed on that on the website and everything else. But as Trevor said, today we're going to be talking about version 2.85, and I've actually got here, would you believe, two pages, a double-sided single sheet of finely compressed fibres, with lots of new features. And of course, this is the beauty of certainly a software-based organ, is that you can adapt, you can update, you can add things, and everyone can, of course, have the benefit of this. Now, while I'm waffling away, Trevor's going to be very cleverly doing his camera work. And in fact, what we started there, we started off with a style called Basic Country Two-Step. Our friend of the business and Wersi star, Brett Wales, has actually done 5 brand new styles for the Sonic system. So these are included with the update. And not only do you get a new style with new introductions and new endings, but you also get sounds to styles as well. So you actually get the settings to go with them. So that was a great rhythm there called Basic Country Two-Step. So we'll talk about that and some of the other styles a little bit later on. But we've got lots of new features. We've got some new ways that you can, or new adaptations to how you can select sounds on the Wersi Sonic. We've got a new MIDI feature. We've got some new controls for the styles. One thing that they've also done is they've revised what we call the factory drum sets. And the drum sets are the actual drum sounds that are used in the style. So if we put that country two-step on, and let's get rid of everything except the drums. Those drums we're hearing there are either programmed by the style programmer, or they use an audio drummer, and that's when there's a little plus on the style. Okay, so that in that case, Basic Country Two-Step Plus is an actual person playing the drums. So, but obviously the sound of those drums can always be enhanced. So by loading in a new set of drums, that really does sound quite something. Factory styles have also been fully revised with all of those. So, let's just quickly take a look in the settings menu. So we have a new MIDI feature. We'll just quickly gloss over this one because the big one is this selecting sounds feature. So on page 3, next to drawbar assigns, you may remember we talked about that one in Patreon videos where we can assign to the drawbars. We now have MIDI in settings, and it lets you adapt the various controls for the keyboards, the solo manual, and it also says that MIDI socket in socket 2 is now designed for use with the 16 MIDI channels for operation with external sequences. Not that I can think of anybody who would do that, Trevor, off the top of my head, but you know, there's some people.
Some people use the Wersi to be controlled from external software.
Yeah, so almost like a sound module kind of thing.
It just simplifies the idea of controlling the Wersi from elsewhere.
Absolutely.
If you're lucky enough to have a Lowry organ beside your Wersi, you could play your Lowry and have all the Wersi sounds on top of it. Yeah.
Absolutely. But the nice thing about this MIDI one socket, but when you send things in, it's just a very, very simple, and you can change the channel there. So that's a nice little adaptation, because there are some Wersi players who like to get a little bit more into the actual system. This is one of the new sort of features. Now in the update, it's called new mapping functions, which I think is the possibly the German translation, but there's new ways and new adaptations into which we can now select voices on the panel, and these are all great little ideas. They're really quite something, because sometimes when I'm playing a Wersi, I think, oh, I wish it didn't do that, or I wish that screen would come up, or you know, so all things like that. Now, of course, once an organ's been designed in the traditional sense, in the old days, it was kind of, that was how the organ was. You know, it wasn't updatable. But with modern organs like Ringways and Wersis, they can be amazingly adapted. So let's go to the factory bank pianos. So we've got a lovely piano sound here. There we go. And while we're talking about the selectors on the screen, can you see now, if I move the upper one selector, can you see that the selector is now the same colour as the background? That's nice, isn't it? I like that, Trevor, don't you? It's lovely. It's
sometimes just those
little things.
They just make you smile.
They do. So we've got red for the lower look. There you go. And is that purple? That's like purple. Purple, blue. Not very useful.
Colour blind,
thank you. But that's just really subtle. And also the text next to it, which shows you the mapping area, the actual zoning of that sound. So in that case, G2 to G6. That's a lot clearer. So little things like that, which are very nice. Now, so on the top, or the right hand, the upper manual, we have got Grand Piano 1. Okay, so if I press the Grand Piano button, do you notice now, when I press it, look, it's changing the voice. What black magic is this, you're probably asking? Mm-hmm. Well, what we've got here is something switched on in the software. Now, normally when you press a voice category, it brings up on the screen all the blue buttons and the picture of the grand piano in that case. But in this case, look, every time I press it, I'm pressing the acoustic piano button and it's cycling through different sounds. There we go, grand piano 2, bright. What have we got here? Grand piano pop bright. Press it again. Grand piano octave. But so let's hold the piano button down, the acoustic piano, and then I can bring up the actual screen. So what's going on there? Well, we have some new ways in the software, which Wersi term new mapping functions. But we like to think of these as new ways as to how you can select voices and also how the Wersi responds to when you're selecting them. So let's go to over here near the picture of the piano, just in case you've had a late night and think, oh, I can't see the piano button, you know exactly where you are. We've got factory, favorites and own, and obviously the filters down the bottom to simplify this. So those are all in the same place. But above those three, look, there's one now called settings. So I press that and then I get a little global settings option come up. And so we've got here the mapping selection. So we've got factory mapping. Now that means that when you press the sound button in question, it will select and go to the built-in factory Wersi sounds, which are in every Wersi model. We've got own mapping, which means we can choose where we want things to move around. We've also got favorites, because of course, as you select voices, the organ learns which are your most used voices and puts them into a favorites list. So if I go to factory mapping, and I'll come out of this screen, as I press the button, look, you can see that it's actually changing, and each time I press it, it goes through one voice after the other. Now that is quite nice, because some people just like to go, well, I just like to keep pressing the button. I don't want to sort of maybe use the screen in this example. But do you notice, look, when I've come out of the display screen, when I press the acoustic piano button on the panel, it's going through the factory presets. Now the reason for that, let's go back into there for a second, is that in the settings, over on the side here, we press the settings button, we've got here something that says show mapping. And what show mapping does, when you tick that, it's literally saying, when you press the acoustic piano button, bring up the sound screen. Because some people like it that way. Now, of course, that's what Wersi's have always done, so that will be set on there as default. But some people say, well, when I'm playing, I don't want that screen to come up, I just want to go acoustic piano, electric piano, acoustic guitar, I just want the sound to change without having the screen to change. So that's where that settings is very, very useful. We can set it to go through the favorites. So when I press it, it will go through the favorites category. There we go. So I can go through honky tonk, I can go through. And of course, don't forget, as you actually choose different sounds within each category of voices, the organ is learning and remembering your favorite sound choices. In fact, while we're on the topics of the topic of favorites, on the favorite screen down here, there's a little edit button. And I can actually delete what the organ has learnt and actually start from scratch, or I can tell the selection that's there, I can freeze it. And then as I play new voices, because we all have our favorite voices in our Wersi, don't we? I have certain organ sounds I like, certain guitar sounds, certain strings. So as I keep going to them and selecting them from the factory setting, the organ's going, oh, okay, that's one you use a lot. Let's put that into the favorites, and so on and so forth. So in that settings menu, there's some very, very clever features. And so if I take off show mapping, okay, so now as I change through, look, it's on the screen, it's going through my favorites, because I've told it to do that. That's a really good feature, Trevor. I think
it's a really good idea.
I think it's a really great idea. Because if you're playing, you just want, say, to get a different piano, you can just tap the piano button. And then one of the most, well, not annoying things, but one thing that people always sometimes think of getting away, because I don't know about you, but I always like to have the main screen on an organ. I like to see the chord and the tempo, the summary of all the sounds. Whereas if every time I press piano, if the piano screen comes up, my habit is to press the X to get back to the home screen. So it's nice to have that little feature there to override, which I think is really quite something.
I think what's nice with that is that it's kind of encouraging a bit more live playing.
Yes. Yeah. Absolutely.
So, the system as it normally is requires you to press a button, then select on
then
the screen
select,
to change
yeah.
sound, which when you're playing is two movements, and of course the buttons and the screen are a fair way apart.
Absolutely.
And so the fact that it will select a sound straight away when you press a category button
is
a good way of changing
absolutely.
Sound quickly while you're playing.
Really is, yeah.
And the fact that you can, via the favourites, choose what sound it is going to start off with is brilliant. And of course, if you build up your favourites in there that you know you're going to be using, and you use that cycle feature, you could almost change all your sounds without having to go to the
absolutely.
Screen at all.
Yeah. And the great thing is, it's the same system in the settings. Styles. There. The settings button, same things. You can actually do all that, direct select, mapping. So the same feature applies there. And as you play certain styles, look, it builds up
your
favourites list. So it's really good. And of course, on the main screen where we've got sounds, there's the entire library of all the voices. And that's always a good way, if you can't find a voice, but you can remember what it was called, you can search for the voice, you can see. It's also a good way of learning how the categories are laid out. So in pianos, look, we have three categories. We've got acoustic, electric, and other. And then within acoustic, there are then the subgroups. And then you can actually select the voice from there and actually load it into your particular voice area.
Yeah, I know we keep doing the plug, but actually I did do a long video on Patreon about it.
Absolutely.
Because it is one of those subjects that kind of makes people gloss over a bit.
Yeah.
Mapping,
sounds a bit complicated. Yeah.
And funnily enough, when I did the video on it, we were in the process of doing the mapping for the Ringway for the Maestro.
Yes, of course, yeah.
So normally mapping is something that engineers decide. You know, they sit down and as I did a picture of my desk actually when I was doing the mapping, you have all these lists of voices and then you have a spreadsheet and you have to say, well, this goes here and this note goes there. And it's something that's normally determined by engineers or us.
Yes, the design team.
The design team,
yes.
The unique thing about the Wersis is that you have all the mapping already done for you by the factory, but you have this flexibility of being able to do your own. And that kind of, in a nutshell, again, is the whole concept of the Wersis is, yes, you can use them at face value as they're all set up, and you never have to worry about any of those features, all the stuff that Tom has been talking about. You don't need to worry about it. But for
I know. In fact, we often gloss over this, but there is actually a full easy mode at the flick of a switch. All of the complicated things. A lot of people still perceive the Wersis as being, oh, never had a Wersi. I've heard they're quite hands-on. But there is a full-blown easy mode where it not restricts you, but it just gives you the safety blanket of having a fixed number of sounds, less control.
Makes it work just like a more normal, as it were.
Yeah,
say, takes
absolutely.
Away some of the flexibility, as it were. Because sometimes it can be a bit intimidating when you start off.
Absolutely.
I think that's a great addition.
I think it's really quite something, and we'll certainly have a little closer look at that.
But just from the point of view that it gives you that more flexibility when you're playing live, just to get to voices quickly.
Very much so.
So it's a nice idea. There's some other things that have been added on 2.85 that we have time to talk about today, but we're going to be doing some more Patreon versions.
Absolutely. Yeah. In fact, one of the exciting Patreon videos, we mentioned Patreon.
Yeah, Patreon.
We're going to go through the extended foot switch options.
Ah, yeah.
Say that 10 times quick.
Extended foot switch options.
And in fact, there are no less than 11, and these are actually quite a lot of them have been requested by you folks, the actual owners, and so that's brilliant. Much like Larry and Wersi, always one thing they had in common, they always listening to customer input.
Absolutely.
And without you guys, you know, they don't get to make these wonderful products. And so there's some wonderful new features in there, but that really deserves a dedicated video. So if you haven't
signed up,
Patreon.com, please do so now. Well, you can still sign up for a year, Trevor, can't you?
Yeah, you can still get a discount if you sign up for a year. In fact, the best time to sign, I mean, if you do want to sign up just on a monthly basis, of course, we have the first coming around tomorrow. So that's your
there
time.
There it is.
Get
there it there. Is. Absolutely. Wait till the first.
Catch up a little bit on the chat while Tom's been
rabbiting.
Explain that feature. So Steve said he's been having some trouble with the full keyboard mode on his OAX1.
Okay.
So we're going to do a Patreon video on that for this week. Because it is handled slightly differently.
Okay.
Al Swift was looking for the sheet music for No Matter What, and I have directed him to a website, Sheet Music Direct. And what's quite nice about them is they have lots of easy play versions of songs that you can download and print out. And John just wants to confirm the name of the book that Lucy's using now. It's Fireside Sing-Along, isn't it?
Fireside, yeah. Something with a fire.
John, there will be a Patreon video coming up where we'll just confirm that and do a link to the book and everything.
Absolutely.
So people will be able to follow what Lucy's doing. Steve Bailey on the Isle of Wight says, connecting my OAX 800 to my Liberty using MIDI, what could possibly go wrong?
What could possibly go right? That's the question.
Well, I did say that, I did comment on this, it's famous last words.
Yeah, absolutely.
Actually, I have a t-shirt that I wear a lot at home now. And it just says on there, it has a couple of bottles, a couple of beer glasses going together, and it just goes, nah, it'll be fine. Famous last words.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And actually, Steve does say he doesn't understand what MIDI is or what it does for you.
Haven't you done it?
Do you know? It's just like, you know, it could well be.
I think I did a video that I entitled Everything You Want to Know About MIDI What We're Afraid to Ask.
Absolutely.
On Patreon. But yeah, because it's something that people do ask a lot. It's one of those things, it's like, it's magic word people talk about, MIDI, and it's going to do these incredible things. It's a bit like when USB came out. Everybody thought that USB was... but MIDI can be very clever. It can also be a bit annoying. And you have to really be clear what you want to get out of MIDI. Before you do it, but it can be very handy. And I have done, joking apart, several videos where we demonstrate what MIDI does, what it's all about, how it works, trying to get over some of the language that's used in it, because they seem like program change and channels and through and ins and outs and all this. And also doing some practical benefits of it, where you can put an expander on your organ and so forth. Steve.
It's been made a lot easier in recent years, I think, with USB MIDI in some ways, but.
Personally, I mean, that's been more complicated.
Well, that's true.
Because
yeah.
you've got to get adapter boxes and things. But it's the problem with MIDI is it wasn't really designed for organs to talk to keyboards. It was designed for computers to talk to synthesizers.
Yeah.
So we're using it for doing something very different from what it was conceived to do.
Yeah. And it is nice that a lot of the even modern day instruments still have what we call legacy MIDI ports, the original 5-pin bin. Mm. So you can still, if you've got a DX7 in the wardrobe, you can dig that out and connect it up.
So Steve, have a look back on the Patreon, on the history. If you search on the tags on the main front page, you can search tags, and if you type in the word MIDI, there's a few videos there we've done chatting about MIDI. And John's actually answered to Steve, basically it allows you to control one instrument from another.
That's it.
Well, again, this is the thing about the language and the understanding what MIDI does. It's not controlling.
No.
That's the very thing. Yeah. It's a trigger. And this is why you've got to be very careful with...
So the actual phrase, MIDI controller keyboard, is that erroneous?
No, because...
get comfy, folks.
No, if you're thinking about, you're not controlling the organ, you're triggering it to play.
Yeah, okay.
That's why people get confused about which way the ins and outs things and goes.
Watch Patreon, folks. This is why. Yes.
Rob says, do the Wersi organs come in black as well as white? Yes, they do.
In fact, the answer is black and white, isn't it?
Black and white, and also, if you have the budget for it, you can have them made in any colour you want.
Yes.
We had the beautiful red one. Do you remember?
We did, the Ferrari red.
We got the red one. Which I put videos on Patreon because they really did look stunning.
Yeah.
And that was made, the customer wanted that particular colour, so we sent a paint sample to Germany, and they made the organ in that colour, which is quite amazing.
But the actual colour's black and white, the actual white is not white, it's pearlescent.
Mm.
So as you move through the light, you get these lovely gold hues, and the black is a
sparkly
bubble, little silver speckles in. So they're very tasteful, very tasteful.
Yes, and as Derek Matt says, there's brown as well. In fact, we have a beautiful black, pergamum downstairs.
Metallic brown,
Metallic brown, which is lovely as well.
Yeah.
I always think it's very 70s kind of brand.
Yeah, absolutely. Retro.
Yeah, which is very in.
Very in.
Very in.
Rob
Appleby says, thanks, Derek. Yes. Peter Dean says, it'll be interesting when Lucy gets to page 112 of Fireside Sing-Along. Her Norfolk accent certainly plays its part. Oh, I don't know what's on page 112. You left us hanging there, Peter.
That's a Patreon video, if I ever heard one. Yes.
We love our Norfolk accent.
It is.
My wife's always mocking me for mine.
You're not from Norfolk, are you?
Well, Suffolk, actually.
No, there is a difference. There's a difference, my dear.
But no, we always extend our vowels, that's the thing. Yes. Extending vowels.
Whereas in Leicestershire, where my family are from, it's flat vowels. That's right, down the road. and all that stuff. Anyway, so shall I try
back to the reason
that we're here. And thank you, and now back to the studio. Yeah. Yes. So we're going to play some more styles in it. Actually, we'll do that now.
Why not?
That would be a good idea.
Because we've done lots of waffling, and you know, it's nice to have to break it up with some music.
It is,
even if it is, even if it is Tom playing.
Hey! So, Friends in High Places, that's the next one. Right, we've got Schlager beer. A Schlager beer is always
good. We always like a bit of Schlager. Yeah, so I'll go and get the beers in.
Hey, it'll be all right. Schlager beer. Maybe that should be our theme.
10:38 on a Tuesday morning. Actually, probably the Weatherspoons over the road is probably open.
They are probably
I could probably get a couple of beers, yes.
With the local gentry frequenting the tavern that is. Schlager beat one. That's another picture of Patrick. Yeah. The Schlagerbeat 1 Disco, second more modern version this is. And in fact, so this is actually an interesting little point. So if I go to style, it says style number 1009, because all the styles are mapped like the voices. But we've got Entertainer, page 1, and if I look for Schlagerbeat Disco 1, there it is. By gad, it works. Mm-hmm. Let's see what now. Don't forget, when you actually press the intros at the bottom of the screen, under the style square, it actually gives you 4 or 5 or 1, however many dark blue squares, and that's the number of bars the introduction is going to play for. The red squares under the bar, it then says those are the beats. So you can actually count along. So let's go for intro 3, synchro start. Let's see what happens. So that's Schlagerbeat. And you see, this is the great thing. So with the update, it's not just the improvements to the operation of the organ, but it's also little things.
Actually, new content, new stuff.
We've had the music archive way back. We had the virtual pipe. I think Ulrich's planning trying to do a virtual theatre organ at some point.
Yeah, we're talking about that. Is liaising with Tom is to find some good theatre organ sounds.
Yes. But of course, these will be in our World of Organs pack. In the next update, so watch this space, which is very exciting. So that was that one. We've then got Basic Waltz. So let's have a.
Actually, while you're doing Basic Waltz, I'm going to nip downstairs and get a copy of the Fireside Books so we can show it to people.
Sure.
Yeah, I'll leave you with doing the waltz.
I'll stay here.
I shall waltz downstairs.
You will. So we've got Ballroom is the category. We've got page 5. So let's nip through to there. And I've completely forgotten what it's called. Basic Waltz Plus. There we go. Very nice. So again, let's press the introduction button, and we can see 1-bar intro, 4-bar intro, 8-bar intro. Let's go with the 4-bar intro, just for the heck of it. Thank you. I thought the computer had gone wrong then. I was like, right. Why is it moving on its own? And you'd seamlessly came back. So there we go. That was Schlager Beat Disco 1. That one was Basic Waltz Plus. We have the Basic 2 step, and we've got Basic Rock and Roll and Basic 80s Pop, which we'll have a listen to those towards the end. Now, of course, as people use Wersi organs, they occasionally come across little things that might need a little tweak here and there. So we have several little improvements to the Basic software. So we've got some customer requests. Oh, a nice little one actually is on the style controls is there's now a what we call a fill intro. So if you press the variation button so it flashes and then play your chord, it will do a fill in before going into the style. Variation C, press it. So you actually get a fill-in as an intro. So almost like an extra intro, which is very, very good. But there's some improvements to MIDI. We've got something in the accompaniment, music archive, total preset. Oh, this is a nice one. Total preset. When you save it with a synchro start, it stops the style when that preset is called up. So if you're playing along, da-da-da-da-da-da-da, press the preset. The synchro start, if you've had it on when you saved it, it will actually pause the style and then you're ready to go as soon as you strike your next chord, almost like a like your own control of a break, which is good. And there's been some improvements to drawbars, we've got some improvements to the Silverman organ, and also one or two what we call bug fixes, little improvements. So it's nice, we've had some great input there from customers, and all of that is improved in one go. Actually, Trevor, one question that came up a week or so ago, we had a gentleman phone up with a Wersi, and he said, I'm still running version, I think it was 1.5.
Wow.
He said, can I update all the way to 2.7, I think
yeah,
it was.
Yeah, if you do and the full installation.
Yeah, it will do the whole lot, won't it?
The only thing to be careful of is that bigger jump is whether or not the organ has enough memory for the new ones. Because when the Wersi organs were originally shipped with the original versions of 1.5, they put 8 gig of RAM in them.
Okay.
And strictly speaking, now for the higher versions, you need 16 really for it to run comfortably.
Yeah.
So you should be able to put it in, but it may make it a bit slower or a little bit buggy.
Yeah.
Buggy. So you may want to put some extra memory in before you go all that far that far with it.
Yeah.
But it shouldn't be an issue.
No.
Somebody also did ask about how the Wersis are going to cope with the new big Windows update. And there's an easy answer for that, is that we ignore it.
Yeah.
essentially, we ignore all Windows updates. Because essentially, all Windows updates are for improving the features within Windows and security.
Yeah.
And we're not actually using any of the features in Windows, we're just using it as a platform.
Yeah.
And because we don't have the organs connected to the internet, we don't need to worry about security issues either.
No.
So we ignore Windows updates.
Absolutely.
If anybody has any experience with Windows updates, is that they never work properly.
No, they will undo, because as I say, the whole thing, as Trevor said, the platform is very specifically tailored to run it as a musical instrument.
So I would avoid any kind of updates, and certainly any updates that they're doing on Windows. We don't want to.
I think we're safe on Windows 11 until probably end of next year anyway. Yeah. So
You know, even when they say, "Oh, they're not going to support it anymore," which will be 10 years down the line. Doesn't really matter, we don't need their support, essentially, because we're not doing any updates. So, not something to worry about.
Yeah, absolutely.
So just on the chat, just catching up.
Well, I was here by myself.
John did ask about whether or not there's any updates for Lowry organs. No, it's just not the way Lowry's are designed. It's unique, really, to the Wersi instruments that they have this very updatable operating system, because, as we said, it's a software-based instrument, which is part of its power. Superpower.
That's my. I have a Wersi.
Well, Isaac is going through at the moment. He goes through these phases where he gets quite obsessed with things, and so he's now watching all of the Marvel movies, all the superhero movies that Disney do.
Wow.
We're working out that he has watched about 15 so far over the summer holidays, and. As a rough guesstimate, probably making a Marvel superhero movie is about $200 million, maybe. Some are more. So I think we worked out that so far he's watched $3 billion worth of entertainment.
For For the same price as our Patreon account, which is amazing.
You know, and it for me, that kind of just like, blimey, you know, yeah, just for him to be able to see that on the screen.
Yeah, and do that,
That's $3 billion have been spent creating basically just some dots moving around the screen. It's just amazing, really.
It is.
You know, if you spent what you could build for $3 billion.
Wow.
It was a weird realisation.
Did you bring the book with you?
Yeah, I did. Excellent. So I got the price wrong. It's $12.99. I don't know why the one Lucy picked up Friday had $5.99. It must have got caught.
The second edition wasn't as thick, so I think it was a much lesser contented.
So this is actually quite a serious book.
It's the third edition,
and it has got lots of songs in it. So it's good value for money, actually. Yes. Even at $12.99, I mean, there's not many things you can get for $12.99 nowadays. And it has, I can't count the songs. I mean, there's lots and lots of them. So Lucy's going to have lots of fun going through all this.
She is, yeah.
It's a great book to have. So I'm wondering what page 112 is.
Oh, yes.
Let's have a look. 112 is... Snitch on Bank.
There you go.
I don't even know that song, Snitch on Bank.
Is it German? I wonder if it's in the archive.
It's a German folk song.
You never know. No, it's not in there. Yeah,
there we go.
The Schwager Melody, Siemen lasst das Traumen. No. That's one for Ulrich to add.
Yeah, there we go. Mm. So anyway, so this is the actual book. So hold it up to that. There we go. Far Side Sing Along version 3, which is Hal Leonard. He's a play series number 17.
There you go. Third edition.
And lots of great stuff in there. Indeed. Only $12.99. Available from all your good music local stores that spell their name Allens.
Absolutely. Plus PNP.
John Bradley has a question.
Oh,
yeah, a question. Somebody's actually asking us a question. Hey!
Sorry. Well, thanks for watching, everyone. What have you got?
We've run out of time, yes.
We've done 50 minutes already.
It's getting that way. It flies by when you're having fun, doesn't it? John says that that's a German drinking song. aren't all German songs drinking songs?
Yeah.
That doesn't narrow it down.
Mit Stein.
Yes.
What we got then?
Sorry.
The question. With the OX
So with the OX one, where does the bass pedal section come in?
That's a good question. That's a very good question.
Let's have a look at the screen.
It's kind of double-ended, really, because this is again one of the most unique things. One of the unique things about the Sonic system is that although it's a keyboard, we tend to think of it a little bit more as a single keyboard organ, because keyboards don't have, and I'm sure Trevor will get this, they don't really have what we would call pedal voices.
Pedal section.
They don't have a pedal section.
So when the guys at Musilam wanted to turn the Tyros or Genos into an organ system, they had to do lots of going through hoops to find a pedal section to use and put pedal sound. Because that's the other thing, is you need pedal sounds, not just a section, but because pedal voicing is quite unique. You need a little bit of sustain on it. You need an organ bass.
Yeah.
Keyboards don't generally have those sounds. So they had to kind of jump through hoops. And even, I mean, on the Genos and the T5, they had to use one of the song voice sections. So
and you have to leave the memory stick in.
And you have to select it selects a MIDI song that doesn't play, but selects a voice for the channel. And it's kind of like, you know, it makes it harder for you to make your own registrations, because essentially it's not something that was built in. It's not what the keyboard's designed to do. Whereas, as Tom was saying, is that the OX1 is an organ already. So it already has available a pedal section.
A dedicated pedal section, which is purple, isn't it?
Yeah.
Our purple section.
Blue. Yeah.
So, and of course, you can play this without a style, because that's another thing a keyboard doesn't really do very well. You have to, this is why so many people are going back, but at the moment there's this mass exodus of people rediscovering the beauty of playing a two-manual pedal organ. But this is wonderful, because if I put auto bass on with accompaniment, you can hear that when I play my chord without a style, I've got strings on the lower and I've got pedal bass. Because there are some songs where you just don't want a fixed accompaniment. Which is lovely. And I can even have the lower manual holding. so it holds on. But you see, on the lower, on the pedal, so if I press the pedal voice, I can then go over to the entire family of voices and I can put on any voice I want. So if I want to have orchestra and timpani, that is now playing the pedals, which we haven't got any pedals on this OAX1. Now, some people would like to play the single keyboard format, but then play the pedals. So how do you do that? Well, you plug in a Wersi pedal board, and instantly you have a pedal section.
Yeah,
and I mean, pedal board. That is literally
no messing around with MIDI or trying to get them to work.
It's all
they
built
plug
in.
Straight in, and they access that pedal section straight away.
Absolutely. Yeah, and one common question is some people say, well, I'm not interested in playing the pedals, but I would like the two manual feel. So with the Wersi Sonic OAX1, you can add the lower keyboard deluxe stand and the lower keyboard expansion kit. And as soon as you plug in the lower keyboard, it automatically plays the accompaniment on the lower, the sounds of the lower go to the lower keyboard. Yeah. And as Trevor said, it's all done.
It's done straight away. You haven't got to do any MIDI, you haven't got to redo all your presets, you've not got to do anything any differently.
Yeah.
Because as I say, it's already got an organ in it.
Absolutely.
That's, you know, when people compare the prices of things like you say the Yamaha Generals or the Korg, with that and the OAX1, they say, well, the OAX1's, you know, a lot more expensive. Well, because it is literally an organ, it has so much more stuff than you find in a normal keyboard.
Absolutely, yeah.
And it has the quality of an organ as well. So,
which is really nice.
And so that expandability is a really nice feature to have. You know, if you want to build up,
Wow.
So Steve Bailey has a quick
Steve.
Question. He says, the cornet on the Silberman lower manual doesn't work, or is there something I'm missing or not doing? Oh, we could try that.
The cornet.
Let's see if we can find it.
Okay, well, we have in the banks, we actually have a Silberman organ setup.
Actually, let's zoom in on that.
Now,
actually, Tom, just maybe put it in the context for everybody else.
Go on.
Could you explain what the Silberman organ is?
I will. So the Silberman organ is an organ in Germany. Silberman was a famous pipe organ maker. And this instrument has been fully working ever since it was installed, I think in the 1700s, I think it was. It is a mid-1700s, a Brocken, so I'll have to look up the actual Gottfried Silberman.
Just Googled him there.
Go on then.
Gottfried Silberman was a German builder of keyboard instruments. He built harpsichords, clavichords, organs, forte pianos, and his modern reputation rests mainly on the latter two, so the organs and the pianos.
Okay, so he was 1700s-ish?
So he was born 1683, died 1753.
So very much Baroque. So what they did at Wersi, they went and recorded this particular instrument, pipe by pipe, note by note, so we then have a visual view of this actual organ. And when we say a virtual organ, because I know some of our organ owners have the theatre organ in the box or the Hauptwerk virtual organ system. Virtual organs tend to be limited to pipe organs and theatre organs. They don't really do much else. But it allows you to actually, in a sense, play virtually the organ that's in the church or the Wurlitzer or the Compton that may have been in the theatre back in the day. And we can actually press on the screen the actual stops in real time. If you listen carefully in the background, you'll hear the echo of the church as the mechanics of the organ are actually playing. Now, the when you select the Silverman organ, you've got one set of stops for the what we call the swell or the Oberwerk, which is the over manual, the upper manual, and the cornet rank, which Stephen is referring to. A cornet is a little one of these little things. And it actually doesn't play.
Oh, there we go.
So there we go. That's why
a little bug.
We can hear the action playing. That should be a little sort of mixture rank, like that one. So possibly maybe something just become disconnected in the software. Maybe so we can.
That's one to report to. Ulrich.
One to report to.
2.86. Have you got that stop for the other keyboard then?
No, because it would be on the great. On the Hauptwerk manual, yeah. So, but all the others seem to be playing. It's the
oh, missing a cornet.
Yeah, but we're missing a cornet three rank stop.
Okay.
I can hear the action playing.
Yeah. Well, I think that's there anyway, isn't it?
Yeah, that's just there. Without the keys pressed. Yeah. So there we go. We shall
report that. But back,
you see,
to Eric.
Just before we go any further, goodness knows we have, when we play with the auto bass on, listen to the pedal section. You can actually hear the organ pedals being played, even though I haven't got any pedals, so the auto bass is playing the actual pedal section of the organ. And that just doesn't happen on a keyboard. Mm. And that's the beauty of it. But that Silverman organ is absolutely fantastic. In fact, I've used some of those settings in the World of Organs pack coming soon for Sonic Instruments.
Yeah. I was just reading about Silverman.
It's interesting going geezer. Yeah.
Interesting geezer.
He's
a bit of a geezer.
That's right.
So apparently he...
He was something to do with the development of the piano, wasn't he, if I remember my reading.
He made a lot of money.
Did he?
Making organs. Yes.
Excellent.
And he was not welcome because he didn't negotiate very well, apparently.
Mm.
Had his own style.
Mm.
And one of his opponents was Bach.
The great man.
Who, unlike Silverman, who tuned in mean tone temperament, preferred a more flexible tune.
Mm.
But apparently his organs are characterised by use of strong reeds,
yeah,
a broad range of stops,
mm-hmm,
and pipes with a high tin content,
okay,
which adds a distinctive brightness to the tone.
Yeah.
He made... over his life, for a lot of organs,
about 50-ish.
Yeah, it was about 50 he made.
If you go onto YouTube and type in German pipe organ or German Baroque organ, it's a very punchy, bright, in-your-face kind of sound, and that is what the sound of the music of that era was.
Mm.
Whereas the French organs are the later ones, which were what we call symphonic organs in the 1800s. They were much more string based, so they had a much fatter, warmer sound, and of course the great Victorian school of organ building, the reeds were very prominent, very big honking sort of sound. So it's amazing how all the different pipe organs have different sounds, and of course the just as theatre organs have got different things, and electronic organs have got
pipe organs, not just a pipe organ. No,
it's not just for Christmas.
I was also just read, actually, apparently he invented the forerunner of the damper pedal.
Wow.
So
he was involved with Chris, what's his name, the Italian.
So I just read that he was the first guys to come up with a system for taking the dampers off the strings when you're playing.
Wow.
So normally on the piano you have the damper that stops the string playing when you let go of the note, so it sounds percussive.
That's right.
And the modern instruments all have a damper pedal which stops that from happening, so that the sound continues, it sustains.
Yeah.
But apparently he was the first to invent that. However, his one was kind of unique in the sense that it was done with a lever,
mm-hmm,
so you couldn't do it with your foot. So you had to stop playing, play, which obviously was not the smoothest of transitions.
No.
And he also separated out the bass and the treble, so you had like a lever for the bass and lever for the treble. And then, obviously, later on, they decided to put that into a pedal.
Yeah.
Well, he didn't, but somebody else had the amazing idea of putting that into a pedal so that you could do it while you're playing.
It's worth YouTubing Mozart Forte Piano.
Mm.
And you hear the ancestor, because a lot of people think the harpsichord went straight to the piano, but it didn't. The modern piano is nothing like the original piano. And the Forte Piano, which some digital pianos actually have samples of that now, don't they? It's a very sort of jangly, almost harpsichord-esque tone, and if you listen to the pianos of Haydn and Mozart, and Clementi, these very first instruments where the keyboard had the velocity control for the first, because before that keyboard players had a very linear world of sound. It was either on or off.
Mm.
And we just take for granted that we can actually put this expression into.
Yeah, I mean and also they're very percussive, all those instruments.
Because
they weren't sustaining.
No, it was straight there. Right, absolutely. Yeah. So anyway, we shall report the cornet three rank to
Uric. Yes,
absolutely.
John's asking, can you make a Patreon video of your entire store again? I think we already did a bit of a walk for a while ago on Patreon, but yeah, we can quite happily. But it's a bit of a mess at the moment. We've been too busy to tidy up.
Show the kitchen. Then.
So we have caught up on the chat, and we've whizzed through the hour. It's been
amazing.
Fun,
I am actually ready to play the finale number.
Wow.
Basic Rock and Roll Plus.
Basically, Rock and Roll Plus, that sounds cool.
Yeah,
nice bit of rock and roll on a Tuesday morning.
Absolutely.
So thanks everybody for your company today.
Good to see you.
Fun.
Thank you.
If Any further questions or things you want us to cover, just email and message us, call us in the store.
Find the website. If you'd like to know more about owning.
Indeed.
A wonderful Wersi.
OAX one, yes, instruments.
Absolutely.
Or anything about the Wersi range.
Yeah. Or any of our give us a bell. Larry's.
I think next week we might do something a little bit different.
We will.
We will probably announce that on the yes. when we do the live link for the video.
Yes.
Though it will be me on my own next week because I think you're on the van, aren't you?
I'm visiting lovely people. Yeah. Yes.
And Lucy will be back on Friday for her live Larry session at 3 o'clock. So any questions you want to ask Lucy, get them in.
Indeed.
In the meantime, I shall hand back to Tom, who will play us out with a bit of rock and roll.
Oh, a little organ going here. Hey. Here we go.